right, y'all. So let's start this episode 3 of After Class, bitch. We got me up in the building.
Say what's up, A.
We got Ari up in the building.
Say what's up, A.
We got Jazz up in the building. Say what's up, A. This is episode, what is it, like 3 or some shit?
3? No. Three. Is it 4? It's 4. It's 3.
3. We've episode only done 3? Okay. Episode 3. And before we get into it.
It's not. He vaping. They all up in his grown man business.
All in your business.
What just happened? Please tell the people what just happened. Jazz.
She thought something was on fire, but it was just Tally's vape. She's a little, you know.
No, like, you no, bitch. I saw smoke from the mirror. I said, are you okay?
What is
Tally is a grown man.
trying to add the fog.
The fog machine.
No, bitch, I was scared. My heart stopped to beat.
He was like, she said, right, okay,
anyway,
take it up the level.
So before we get into some things this episode, we want to thank you guys for listening. We want to thank you guys for watching us and being so entertained.
Yeah.
We have so much to talk about and so much to say. So we're really excited for this journey.
Hell yeah.
Remember, you guys, Full Out TV is sponsoring every single episode. So if you guys want to dance this quarantine, this lockdown, whatever we about to get out, make sure to go to Full Out TV. Pick any video, type in After Class. Let us know that you've been watching.
Yeah.
And get a cute little discount from us.
Okay.
So, sis, you went on vacation? That was real quick, bitch.
Okay, so I went on.
Tell the people.
Right. So I went on a vacation.
I blinked. He was gone. I blinked
and
again.
And he was back. Back. Okay.
On the couch.
So I went to this place called Catalina Island.
Okay, cute.
It's like, it's still LA County. It's literally right down the street. You go to Long Beach, take a little boat, go to the island. Mm. So when we were in Jamaica, we got scuba certified. Right?
How do you get scuba certified?
So you just have to. So the way it happened in Jamaica is we went into this. What is on my head? We went into this pool with the gear on, mm-hmm. and we have to practice like the breathing. We have to practice like
bitch, the hand signals. No scuba?
Oh, bitch! Oh,
well, I gotta practice.
Oh, you do gotta practice the scuba, bitch, because I thought the same thing. You know me. I was like,
bitch,
I got
get
this.
In the motherfucking
just
water
get in the water and breathe.
Bye, like, yeah.
That's all you gotta do. No, bitch.
No,
because
bitch.
First of all. When we
really?
Was in, yes, because, no, listen. So in Jamaica, it was real cute. During the day, something cute, like it was nice. So in Catalina Island, I was trying to be like daredevil of the year and go scuba diving at night. Okay, right.
Okay, that's the thing.
Okay, right. So I'm like, bitch, I'm a G. Like, I can go scuba diving
and
like, what's
humble.
The worst that they can happen? Oh,
humble
real
bitch.
Quick. Okay, so.
The ocean is motherfucking dark
so,
down there.
Okay, so that was the least of the problems, though. First of all, the current.
The moon do change it.
The current.
I know, I swear to God. Oh, God, science tells you that.
Bro.
The moon changes the way.
The moon and the sun changes the.
Well, it must have been having a bad night because that night, first of all, okay, let me just paint you a picture.
You couldn't even get underwater.
We couldn't even get into the buoy to get down to the, okay.
Come on,
so buoy. So we got our gear on, right? We got a wetsuit on because it's cold.
You set up, it's serious.
Oh, yeah. Bitch, I've never
and she's
been,
like, let me tell you this.
I have
quick.
Never
hold
been
on.
So terrified in my life. They put the tank on. They put the wetsuit on. They put these big-ass weights so we can barely walk.
It's heavy?
Yes, heavy. Okay. You can barely walk. You're like, so you're walking down these stairs. Now, in Jamaica, they took us out on a boat. They drop you, right? Put you, which is better, way better. At first, I thought it was not. No. In Catalina Island, you walk out on stairs. Now, as we're walking out, the waves are like, like crashing into us. I mean, Nicole gets knocked back. Like I can barely fucking breathe. It was terrible.
So we make it out
to the buoy, right? Which is like the little floating thing, and you have to get on a little like rope to get down to the bottom of the ocean.
Okay.
We have flashlights. It's pitch black. Pitch black.
Yeah, see, no, that's a no for me. That's a no. Why would you want to go down there?
Because I thought I was going to see something cool, like glow in the dark fish or something. I thought I was going to see something cute. There was nothing down there
it's
for
Animal
me.
Planet. Animal
there
Planet.
Was nothing down there for
because
me.
Because Animal Planet has segments for things
right.
like that.
So
that
see,
you don't need
so
to.
See, I ran into a bigger problem than Nicole
Animal
and
Planet.
The guy. I ran into a bigger issue. Apparently, I'm the one that was just fucked up. So I let them go down first, and here I am just up at the buoy by myself. I get down there, and on your vest, you have to press like a button to inflate and to deflate. It's a lot, bitch. I'm telling you, it's a lot.
Fair.
So as you're going down, you have to deflate, okay. right? Each little moment, and then you have to clear. It's a lot, like clear thing.
I get to the
bottom, and apparently I didn't deflate enough, so I float back up.
To an area.
So you got Nicole and the guide at the bottom, and here I am just like with my flashlight, like, God, there's nothing that I can do. So I get back to the top, and I literally looked at Nicole and was like, I don't think I can do this. Like, I literally don't think I can do this. I'm about to, like, forfeit. And she was like, I mean, tell me, like, what do you want to do? Do you want to do it now? And then, you know me. I'm like, no, bitch, you can do it. You can fucking do it.
Right, right.
So finally, I breathed through it. I made it to the bottom. Once I got to the bottom, it was cool. There was, like, hella lobster. There was, like, these big-ass fish. Yeah, there was, and the fish are sleeping, but fish don't have eyelids. So they're just floating. They look like they're dead. But they're sleeping.
I'm too drunk for this.
Bitch, I'm telling you, yes, like they're literally like this.
In one place, bitch, or are they going around?
In one place. They're just like this. So I took my fin and I like tapped one. I know I felt bad. Because I'm like,
it's the fin for me.
So I took my fin and I like tapped one and it was like, and then it like woke back up and then it went back into its place. But its eyes are open the entire time. Because they don't have eyelids.
I don't think I like that.
Bitch,
yeah,
it was.
Because you know why? Because you're not in control in the water.
You're not in control. So I felt like I was prey. I literally felt like I was prey. During the day, it's beautiful. You can see everything. I literally felt like one moment I was going to turn this way with my flashlight and there was just going to be something sitting there waiting for me. So I told him, I was like, we got to wrap this up.
I want y'all to comment. We got to make this short. This or watching this. I want y'all to comment and let us know if you guys would go scuba diving in the dark.
At night.
That's where you got me fucked.
I would not wish that on my worst enemy. I'm going to be real.
The people who go scuba diving to get married?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you've never seen that?
What if you drop the ring?
They are so, people try to be so different that people go underwater and like have their whole ceremony underwater.
What?
Isn't that crazy? How can you say, you can't even do that?
You can't even say I do. Yeah, because you can't even say I do. You're like,
Yeah, but that's the thing of it.
I mean, because it's cool. I mean, because it's like, oh, different.
That they'll go underwater and like have a nice, pretty picture underwater, and they kiss and all of that.
Nope.
That's a no for me, honey.
Bitch, that's a no for me.
My honey is in the building. If we're lucky, he might come in and be in a part of this episode. But honey, would we do that? Is that something that you might be interested in? Mm-mm. Nah, because we need to be.
You're not even gonna have a bridesmaid.
Because I'm not gonna be.
No, y'all are definitely going down.
I'll be down there. You know me. I'm scuba certified, bitch. I'll be down there. What you need me to do? I'll be the flower girl with my fucking scuba suit on.
Okay.
But no, basically moral of the story is scuba diving is really fucking fun. Like, it's super fun, but just don't do that shit at night. It's not the one.
And let's talk about this, though, because everybody knows Ari to be the curly-haired chick. Mm-hmm. Now she got her weave in, and you got that whole motherfucking wet. So tell me about that. You itching, huh?
Oh, my God.
We all got our weaves in. We all know that.
Yes, so I got
so
my...
So let's talk about weave.
I got my shit wet.
Apparently, I don't know
apparently,
much.
Apparently, we got mildew hair.
We got mildew hair. Bitches be doing it wrong. How do we clean our hair? It's fucking hair. Is this real hair? Aliya, where did you...
is this real hair? I'm sorry, bitch.
Because where did you order from? What do you mean?
I got mine from Hair R Us. No.
What?
Yes.
Where is that?
Shout out to Hair R Us. That's on Fairfax in Hollywood.
Yes.
I remember Hair R Us.
Yes.
Nah, I get mine from Mystic Mermaid. Yes, go to Mystic Mermaid. That's my girl, Zerika. She be doing my hair or whatever. I don't know where she gets her hair from, but either way, my question is, I can do whatever I want to this hair because it's not like this hair is alive.
Correct.
It's not attached to your hair.
Correct. So you can fry it if you wanted to.
But it's the actual hair that is connected to your skull. That's...
Right!
Okay, so...
You know when you get... But
if you clean it, though, doesn't it smell good? I don't get it. If you clean it and you dry it, what's the problem?
Yeah, if you dry it good, bitch. Okay, maybe because I've been wearing weave since I was a kid, and I used to, you know, just, like, rub a dub dub in the tub, and then I would just let my shit get out. My mom would be like, bitch. You dirty ass motherfucker. Like, why the fuck do you smell like that? Dusty, crusty, Krabby Patty moldu.
Y'all, if you guys have never worn a weave or paddocks, that y'all, your head be smelling.
I don't know if I've ever. It's John's face for me.
Right? He's like.
It's John's face behind the camera.
You guys wouldn't think that head smells. Ooh, this head smells.
But it smells.
You bitches are some dirty ass bitches.
And we be sweating. Ooh, yeah. When you really put it into perspective.
It's gonna be hot. Mm-hmm. Okay, so when you wash it, I don't like to get my braids wet every time because it just takes too fucking long to dry it. Mm-hmm. Don't nobody got time to, like, put the blow dryer right there. So I'd be, like, pulling it.
So you only wash your hair. Hair, if it's just this. That's how I feel.
I need to be washing
my inches.
I mean, if I don't feel that scratch, like if I don't feel like
I'll
get in
the shop and let them do that when I could sit under the dryer. But when it's Jasmine White is just.
But why wash?
It will get crunchy.
Because it'll get crunchy, right?
It's still like reacts.
So we're just supposed
hair.
To just. So we're just supposed to just deal with it.
Like you still like brush it and take care of it. Like I still like deep condition it and put like a little leave-in on that hoe and shit. Mm-hmm. Like I take care of it so these bitches last.
Right.
How long do you have your? How long do you guys keep your leaves in?
Well, I got mine in today, and I'll probably
come on. Keep that on until what?
Bitch, what day is it?
Till the end of the year.
Right.
Girl, boo! Don't play with me, cause
yes. So the end of the year,
I'm not like October, Halloween.
So a cute little, so a month and a half.
It's a little over a month though.
So a month, like a month and a half.
That is a long time.
So I'm a cute little, for me. I'm a cute little 3 weeks.
A cute little 2 to 3 weeks.
Yeah, I'm a cute little 3 weeks.
It'll last.
You're right, but this scalp will not last.
No, sometimes I feel it. Sometimes it moves a little too much for me.
Yes, like when you make yes, when you wet your hair and your whole.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm like, I'm sorry. Is this a wig or is this sewn in?
Like, why is my whole unit like this?
Because it do that.
That's what I don't like.
That's what I don't like.
I don't like that either.
You gotta redo this.
Like the whole unit is moving as one. I don't like that. I don't like that.
How do you guys feel? What do you guys? What's your best process in adding hair? Like, I remember I used to do tape-in extensions.
No.
I love tape-in extensions. Well, at least I have my textured hair. Yeah, because I have more of Asian hair or whatever.
Yeah, no,
so I can just tape it in and, ooh, it blends so well. But I just feel like it doesn't blend well. Like, when I flip in class, it'd be like, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I know a couple people that look like that. It's just that with your hair. It's just like,
yeah, that's true. I like the sew too.
I love the sew in because I can dance with it. You know, my hair. Yeah.
It makes me feel secure.
Makes me feel secure.
Yeah, makes me feel secure.
I can play with color. I could play with length.
Yep.
But it's the wig. What do y'all think about wigs? I don't know about that.
A wig for me, if I can't take that bitch on and off, like that's it for me. I can't do the sew the wig in because after like 3 days, I'm over it. Like I think the last time I had a wig sewn in was my pink wig, and I had it in for 4 days, and I was like, this is stupid. This is dumb. Mm-hmm. Especially because the lace, I hate when you can see lace. Like, I hate when you can see it lifting. Glue. The glue, when it lifts for me, I'm like, ugh. That is so raggedy. So when I had my pink wig, I literally had to cut Barbie doll bangs because I was like, y'all aren't gonna see this lifting. I'm sorry, that's just not gonna happen.
Actually, that might be cute.
Yeah,
though.
So you don't see it lifting, but it still just does not feel, I don't like wigs.
Like, I like to have my little leave out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't like to have my full head compressed like that.
Yeah, no, a wig is not for me. I think a wig is just for like a shoot situation. Put it on, you got the cornrows. Right.
I swear you're finna get a fucking concussion. Just gank.
I go like this.
Y'all, you cannot, if you do not, okay.
Oh, God.
You can't just do a little tap tap.
No, you gotta beat the fuck out of your head. You gotta beat the fuck out of your head.
You gotta go all out.
Yeah,
okay.
You do.
You gotta go all out.
So I don't know why people be tripping when
I'm the rhythm.
It's the rhythm.
Give myself my own.
Can they hear this?
I mean, it's like.
Do that in the mic.
Do that in.
It feels so good.
It does. And I just scratch my. Oh, God.
Mine's fresh, so I can't relate.
Right. Well, bitch, I gotta.
I can't relate.
I got a massage when I was in Catalina Island. I told the masseuse to stick her fingers in my
she
weave.
She pulled them out and said,
"Yeah, I was." I told her, I was like, "Please stick your fingers in my hair. Don't be afraid to ocean. Don't be afraid to ocean."
Ooh,
It was before.
Have a particular smell.
It does.
Rehearsal.
It does.
Which brings me to my next topic.
Ooh, how does this flow into this one?
I'm scared. What's the topic?
I know. The topic is your man in bed smelling all that.
Smelling your
dildo. Your
baby, you fine and all, but that shit.
But that shit stank.
Baby, I'm sorry. Keep your head lower.
Like, please keep your head
lower. No, it's this. Like, if you were laying in bed.
And they're like.
Kiss. And then.
They're like. And they're like.
Baby.
They're like,
I'd be scared.
Jelly.
They're like, never mind.
Honey.
How her scalp smell?
No.
Do it before?
Fortunately, no. Her scalp has been well maintained.
See, that's what I'm talking about. Right.
Good.
Right. Okay. That's what I like.
I've never had a guy say it stinks, but I have had him be like, get that itchy shit off me. And I'd be like, you're rude. It looks good.
For real?
Cause, you know, because he'd be feeling like the tracks and shit. And he, you know, he was like, I like natural bitches where I can play with it. Well, I'm not her. So you're going to play
right,
with
so
the tracks.
Sorry. Right.
Chugga chugga choo choo ho.
I do want to get a guy's perspective, honey. And, well, no, I don't want to. I want to get perspective. My honey's in the building if you guys are listening. So I know for you, see, I guess it kind of depends on the guy. Like, people be saying, they like, we want our girl natural. Ooh. We like her, like, with the real hair, without makeup, mm-hmm. sweats, all of that. And then I just feel like, I don't know. I just feel like they respond better when we are.
When you are.
I feel frumpy when you're if I ain't got it in.
Pulled up. I feel that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So honey, what? So honey, what is that? Why don't you get? Can you get in? Honey, why don't you get in? You're gonna be our guest.
Yeah,
today.
Get in.
Okay, so we got honey up in the building. Say what's up.
Hey.
We got honey up in the building. Say what's up.
Hey.
It's the love romance for me.
Huh?
Just, I hate you.
So anyway, what I was asking to get a guy's point of view, how do you like your before me? How did you like your women?
I'm exiting.
You know
your
what
building.
I'm saying? Because it's like I think we just have a two different perspectives or like two different. I don't know. Like some guys are like we like them
we
natural.
We prefer natural, right.
But then sometimes it's like some guys. I remember my dad. My dad always like not trained me, but when he raised me, I could not leave the house looking crazy.
Yeah, right.
He's like, you gotta
that's
fix
how
your
I was.
Hair.
Yeah.
Your clothes gotta match. Like you gotta be
pulled up.
Yeah. 100%. You know, I think that's what he did with my mom too when they were together.
They're like, you can't be
so
leaving
it's like
this
we
house
have
looking
that kind of
me.
Man and the
and
other kind of me.
Right.
So what do you think? From your perspective, what is your thing?
Me, you know what I'm saying? I'm
we got where we self-made up in this bitch.
Right.
So we got to this is our mind.
We got to pass it around.
I'm kind of balanced or whatever. So I think I favor tomboys. I used to favor tomboys as girls. So like think like a Sanaa Lathan, loving basketball.
Right.
Like this kind of girl who's like naturally beautiful, but then when she actually did dress up,
pull
you
got
to do a little better than that. She was struggling. When she did in the movie.
No, yes, she was.
Oh!
I was like,
I was like, I hope she doesn't watch this, Mika.
No, in the movie, yeah. Right, she had that homecoming dress on.
Queen.
No, I feel that though. She had that homecoming dress on.
Okay.
That's how I was. I didn't like the girls who was like overly done.
Right, because you can kind of tell.
Yeah.
When they try too hard. Exactly. Right, trying too hard.
Yeah, that's my.
Mm-hmm, okay. Mm-hmm. What do y'all think? What type of woman are you? Are you the type of woman that is like balanced? Because I think I'm more of like the balanced type where if I don't need to try so hard, like if we're not going anywhere, I will express myself naturally and I will literally go a couple days without any makeup. And
right.
I think even right now, I just feel like I've done so much with my hair lately. Like I'm so ready to go back natural. I'm so ready. Like I think I love that myself that much that I can, sometimes I lose myself when I'm trying to like
be this,
have the different looks.
Yeah.
So
I think I have a perfect balance.
And where most women mess up is like, their feelings get hurt when they take all that stuff off. And then they feel like,
bitch, who was you?
Because they put so much on that when they take all of it off, they're not even their same.
Yeah.
You know, because you pulled off all your
eyelashes.
And,
yeah.
You know, your edges done got snatched.
Fucked
all,
up.
All that stuff. So it's like, you gotta do something.
Just
put on your beauty, but you gotta be able, when you take it off, you gotta be.
You have to be that person too. Yeah.
You can't look like. I cannot function
without this hair. Yeah, without that's
yeah,
true.
Yeah, I mean it's just. What do you guys think?
I personally,
I think we're all balanced. I think we're the balanced type. Because like
straight
even
daddy and then bitch. This bitch can switch it up.
What? What do you
nah,
mean?
Nah, she can give you straight daddy.
Real like tomboy mask, and then she can give you.
No, we can be in it.
Okay.
Yeah. I personally actually miss my curly hair. Yeah, like I do miss, and I don't know if I miss it just because my head just feels like ass right now, like because it's just so bad, right? Or if I don't know, I do miss my curly hair, but I think what I love about this is the length. Like once my curls get to this length, I'll be satisfied. So it's like I am more of like a natural kind of girl, but I do like to switch it up a lot. So it's just, I don't know. It's just, I think I'm in the middle of like, okay, like I do want to switch it up and go over the top sometimes, but I do like being like this natural, you know, a natural girl who's just chilling and not trying to do the most. I think it just depends. I think all of us, it kind of just depends.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think all of us is a good balance. I think we know when we want to pull
up. Plus, we're not even trying so hard. When we do these podcasts, like right now I have a little bit of makeup on because I had a shoot earlier, but like
we ain't got no makeup on.
They don't got no makeup on. They're fresh face.
Right. Right. Yeah. I think it depends. I think it's a good balance.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Who's in charge of the bedroom? Raise a hand. Who's in charge of the bedroom? Jasmine.
I'm a good both. Yeah, that's how it is with me, Nicole. I'm a good both.
I'm gonna say it's different in a relationship.
Like, am I tired? Am I tired?
Well, okay. How was it different, Jazz?
Well, not to expose myself, but you know, if you have like a little sneaky link, I'm gonna do what I want to do. It's not about you. It's about me. I called you over for an
so
experience.
I can
I'm
do,
not doing
right.
this because I love you and I want to please you. I don't give you
I don't care about you.
What's going on over there? Did I get it? So I'm right. I know my spot. Let me just, okay. And did you finish? No? Well.
Not my problem.
It's really not my issue at this point.
No, I'm not like that. When you love somebody, you know,
you want
them to enjoy that experience. When I was in love and shit.
You wanted them to enjoy
that
was, it.
Yeah, right. I did want them to enjoy.
I still
that,
be kind of selfish, actually. But I still like actually. To be in.
You said what?
I said I still be kind of selfish. Sometimes I'd be like, don't care.
Sorry, bitch.
Don't care. I've had a long day.
Nah, I had a long day.
It's just been, I needed this for me.
Yeah. I mean, it's like that sometimes.
From a guy's perspective, what do you think? What do you think about girls who are maybe overly aggressive when they know what they want and they try to like lead the whole mm-hmm. situation, and do you feel emasculated maybe sometimes? Or?
Nah. I love that. You know what I'm saying? I enjoy every flavor of that experience, and sometimes it's cool to be in charge and throw you around the room and mm-hmm. like that. Yeah, but then sometimes right. it's mm-hmm. good to be mm-hmm. it's good to be handled, you know what I'm
right.
saying?
Right. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you know, see, that's how Nicole is. That's the same shit.
If you feel emasculated by that, you're probably self-conscious. You're probably insecure.
Right.
That's valid.
Well, before your guys' situations, have you ever? I was just talking about this earlier. This is so awkward. Being in a situation where you can like see the guy being emasculated and get insecure and just like stress out
and pull back.
Like,
yeah.
No, I don't think I've ever.
Done that. I don't think I've ever been
okay,
in that situation.
My last
either.
Experience. Sorry if you're watching.
Just insecure. Just
watching
just.
Because it was real bad. Just real crappy patties.
So what happened?
That's messed up.
What did he just held back? Like he just closed off because he was like, oop.
His little face would just turn so red and he would bury his face and he would just be like, oop, you make me so nervous. Like I'm a very dominant bitch. Like I have a strong personality. And I mean, I think we're all very comfortable with our sexuality and just being these sexual beings and our sex appeal. Mm-hmm. And I think with dance itself, like, bitch, you gotta pull from some to be able to dance the way we dance.
Right,
pull
dance
it
is sexual.
Experience it.
Yeah.
I'm not thinking about goddamn SpongeBob while we neighbors know my name.
Right.
So, I'm not thinking of SpongeBob
while neighbors know my name.
But that's real life, so it's like you get in these predicaments and you're like, I'm about to, you feel me, do what I do best, and you kind of just tap into this, you know, alter ego, you feel good, you feel sexy, and he just was not ready. He's talking his shit, and I'm like, you're gonna talk your shit, I'm gonna talk my shit. As soon as I started talking my shit, he said, I said, you gotta go. What the fuck going on? And then I'm rude because I'm not gonna deal with that. Cause what the fuck?
So what'd you do? You packed up shit
and head out. I'm gonna
and
head
leave.
Out. Then leave.
Get
that.
Then
leave.
Got nothing. Goodbye. Because baby, oh bless his heart, just scared. And then he was like, you're so beautiful. Like you just make me so nervous. Like you're very dominant.
That's a turnoff for me.
Oh
yeah, that's a turnoff for me.
Delivered.
I can't deal with that.
Didn't even open the text after that because
I can't deal with that.
Like,
But you need to match me. Like nope, not I. At least match me.
Yeah, there is.
Test
there
me,
is.
Challenge me. Make right. me feel like I want you to be able to throw me on the room and then be like, hey, I'm right. coming right back after you. Not right. no.
Right. If you want to get on
if you want to get on top, yeah, like that. That I don't like that.
You knew what the fuck you was getting into. You saw my Instagram. You DM'd me.
Right. Right. I don't. Yeah, I don't like that because I feel like I like to be in charge, but then I also like to be the one that's handle. Not. Yeah. Like I don't know. And if you're coming to
I
me
want
with
it to be a movie.
If you're exactly and if you're coming to me with shy energy and like all that right. that like holding back energy, I'm just automatically oh. just. Dry, like
right.
I don't. That's it. Like I can't. Yeah.
Have you ever pretended, you guys?
A girl.
100%. Oh yeah, I've had to
have
many
you
times.
Honey? You have pretended, huh? Yeah, I remember
I
that.
I had
I'm
to pretend a... once.
Damn.
It was just bad, and I was like,
how do guys pretend?
Did
just scared.
I know.
And I was just like, yo, like,
I'm sorry.
I was having a conversation with myself, like, I'm really gonna have to fake it. Like,
when did you realize that? Like in the beginning? Because
why am I?
Obviously, this was not. Let's just be clear.
This was not with her, right?
This was not with me. Me
okay,
and
like, the other night, I was just. Like,
I was like, fuck.
You know what, baby? You really didn't know,
right? But the other night, I know, just pissed.
The amount of anxiety I have.
Let's just make this clear for whoever's watching and listening. We are being open with our sexual stories. We're all adults here. We do not need to be all...
Put the kids to bed.
Right.
Right, put the kids to bed. Yeah.
Right.
If you are under 18 or something like that, please stop listening or watching.
Turn it off right now.
Or maybe learn something.
Right. Right.
Sex ed, uncut.
Okay.
Talk to your mom and your dad.
But yeah, so when did you realize that you had to pretend...
I think
because that is kind of awkward.
It wasn't
like,
at the beginning. It wasn't at the beginning because at the beginning
you're like,
you're ready.
Yeah.
Like, oh, you're like, oh, it's go time. It's go right. time. You know what I'm saying? And it was one of those like, it was never like highly considered. Like, oh, I'm gonna get at that. It was just.
It just happened. Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
The circumstances are here.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And then it's like, okay, you're the last one left. Okay, here. Okay.
I'm getting up.
I got to go. My baby was a player in college.
Okay.
You know, like what you hang around for?
Right.
Not parking lot pimping.
Okay.
Yeah, parking lot pimping.
But yeah, we got into it and
it just wasn't it.
It just wasn't it. I tried everything.
Oh, and you were like, nothing's working.
You know,
yikes.
What I'm saying?
Why,
oh,
so why did
give
you stop
a
it?
Special attention.
Oh, but shit.
That is, I was like, that's when I knew it was bad.
Right.
And I was like.
She had that dap.
You're like, none of this will work. No position is going to work.
Like, something's got to give.
There's something that's going to work.
And I bet she was just like.
She's like, right.
She's crazy. See, what was the worst? Was the face. That she made.
That we gotta be careful, y'all. We
gotta
be careful.
We gotta
be
careful.
Enjoying our shit too
much.
We're not
aware.
We're not aware of these faces that we be making.
Yes.
So I'm aware.
I'm aware. I'm aware. I be trying to be cute.
Yeah.
I be like.
You gotta think about it. You gotta.
No, Tally told me the story, so I was like, oh yeah, we can't be
looking crazy, like
because we be.
Shit, that is the funniest
aware.
Thing
Make
I have ever heard.
So you
can know what
especially
you look
if you're on the
like,
top and they're looking
and
up
you're
at
just like,
you. You got a booger.
Nostrils is flared.
And then do the leg to the face.
You gotta remember what that face feels like.
That, yeah, exactly.
Ever since I heard this story, everybody needs to listen to everybody. Needs
oh,
to pay
shit.
To these. If you're listening, you gotta be so aware. I know it feels good. I know you be enjoying it.
But, bitch.
But they gotta continue.
Right, because.
There's a job to be done.
Crying.
You know what I'm saying? And if you're losing.
If you look a mess.
If you look a mess.
Then I don't want it no
wait,
more.
The
like,
too.
Yeah,
you can't.
From a guy's point of view.
Look, it was a symphony of.
Huh?
Just
oh, right. God.
Because hold on, I need to see this angle.
Not only, you know, the goods were
right.
used.
Right.
They were pretty
old. Oh. There was no walls. Okay.
I'm not saying, you know, I'm not trying to say, like, I'm the biggest guy, but I'm
Yeah. Yeah.
My baby is great. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, my baby's good.
Right, right.
And I was like, all right, cool. That's, wow, that's the first time. It's the first. Okay, cool. But then the faces that she was making combined with the sound.
Sound.
Mm. I can't.
Not the both.
It was just not. It was like,
how did you finish that though? Like, how did you even get through? Yeah, I would have been like,
that's when I knew I was gonna be a good actor.
Did you cut it short?
Hire me.
Hire me. Did you cut it short though? Were you like, okay, let's wrap this up. Let me just act like I finished.
Ah, good question.
You know what I'm saying? Like, because I've had to do that. I've had to be like, oh, no. I just came fast.
It was good. It was good.
I'm stressed.
Look, I finished the game out. You know
okay,
what I'm saying?
Right.
It's like, you know when the team getting blown out, you know what I'm
right.
saying? The ref, I'm like, all right, we're going to let him play one more inning.
Let's just finish it out.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Let me give you your sympathy vote. We watch Big Brother.
God.
Right.
So I put right.
some time in the meter, you know what I'm saying?
Right. And then finished it out.
She don't even know.
And she don't even know. She's like, I put it down on him.
I was like, I would finish like this, so all right.
Let me just act like.
No, I would finish like this.
Oh,
not one.
Please exit.
Never again.
Oh, God.
Have you guys ever pretended?
Oh, 100%.
Yes.
100%.
Yes. In our relationship,
fast.
In our
quickly. Like, oh, really? Oh, wow, you made me come so fast. Thank you.
Right.
Bitch.
It's
easier. Yeah, it's so easy to stroke the ego that you just have to stroke the ego a little bit. And it's like,
we'll make them think they,
oh, they did something great. And then you're like, let's get this over with.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Damn, that sucks.
It's pretty shitty.
Especially when you've been anticipating it.
Yes.
Like, ooh, you're about to get
yes. And then you get it, and it's like.
And then you get there.
And you're like.
I definitely had that experience.
Yeah. I some of those too. Not the worst one.
Sometimes, like, the best looking people probably just don't got it.
Don't have
they don't
it. 100%.
And then it's kind of like that. I don't know.
Yeah.
Have you ever just not felt it?
Yes.
Ooh.
Like they're in, and you're like.
And then you're like. Oh. You're like, I'm sorry, are you finger?
Okay. That's why I don't like.
I've yeah. dead ass said, I'm sorry, I don't like being fingered. He said, stop playing. I said, oh.
Wait.
Damn.
Oh, bitch. That's not the one.
I know. She knows too.
I think you told me.
Yeah.
Too.
Just
yeah.
uncomfortable. And he really was like, grind. I was like, so what that's your.
Yikes. And then it just sucks because guys, like
and
you
they
have
think
to,
it's just great.
Yeah, you have to, and you have to really stroke their ego
but I'm like,
to get
no
through it.
Has no one told you that there's a lack thereof? Because I feel like men talk. I don't know. Maybe you do. Maybe you don't. But I just feel like you would know.
Every guy knows.
Right.
And so then don't talk about it. Like you finna.
They just hope that you're the one that doesn't.
That don't
that
notice.
That isn't affected
go,
by it.
Are you gonna
right.
go along with it?
Oh, girl, no, I mean, girl.
Right, you're going to stroke their ego to go, right, to make them feel better.
And I was not the one to do that because how do you stop
something like that? Like, how do you?
Very straightforward.
I've had to stop. I've had to stop. And I would
have to stop it?
Yeah, and I'll just act like, oh, shit, like I'm too drunk.
Ooh.
Just hit him.
That's a good one.
Just hit him with
that's a bad excuse.
Just hit him. No, no.
It's a guy excuse. Because sometimes if a guy can't get
but
hard,
I've been
or
too,
if a guy can't finish.
Yes, that's true. But I've been too drunk. I have been too drunk to where I'm like, bitch, first of all, I'm about to throw up. So let's just talk about that.
That's
but,
a good excuse.
You know, so I'll just be like, I'll be like, I'm so sorry.
Say, well, just later, then. You ain't
got
to do nothing.
And,
and then bounce, bitch. It's going to be a later.
Right. That, like, it's just like, I'm sorry. Just but you just have to stroke. It's all about stroking the ego. Like, oh, I would really want this. Like, damn, like, that really fucking sucks. But
that's a great excuse.
I'm too drunk and I just don't feel good. So maybe next time. And then just hit him with the block.
Well, what are you going to say now? Because you can't use that one anymore.
Now that it's just on national.
Well, bitch, I'm taking, so.
Taking now. Yeah, that's right.
Come on, Jazz, what you
going to I've hit her with the I'm too drunk
what
a couple times.
What is this?
What is this? What am I supposed to do with this?
Maybe, I dead ass told him.
Deal here.
I
what's
told,
the
like,
deal here?
Fingered, and he was like, I'm not. I said,
that is not, I'm not.
And
that's
then
pretty.
I flipped it on him. I was like, you don't know what consent is?
Okay. Not hit him with the you don't
because
know.
Because I was like, I didn't know it was
button.
In me. Yeah.
Right.
Because I said, I didn't know it was in me, so I'm not prepared for this. I wasn't prepared.
Oh,
you don't have a
my God.
I didn't know that we weren't doing this. And then he stopped and I left.
Oh, my God.
Ooh, that's kind of depressing.
Because
that's,
I was really just like.
That would hurt my self-esteem.
What
okay.
the fuck is going on here?
This
is a little
too pumped. That.
Did he pay $1 for the lip?
One,
okay,
two.
Did he pay
$1
for the lip?
Though.
Maybe two.
He paid $2 for the lip.
It was rough. And he just swears to God that he fucked my life up. Mm. You know, he hits my line religiously.
Yeah. Yeah, see, that's how they be thinking. But you know what? You just, that's how they be
business.
Thinking. Bless their hearts.
Yeah.
That's well, funny. Damn, Tally. Well, I'm sorry that happened.
I know. With the horse face. With the horse face.
With the horse face.
Be aware.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Take a cute little video.
You just
take
have
a cute
to feel.
Video. Practice in the mirror. I think a mirror definitely needs to be
it does.
Present.
It does. A mirror needs to be present. But I feel like it's a mental thing. Like, if I feel good, then I'm going
to
look good.
That's
like,
what I was just about to say. See,
yeah, if I feel.
Sometimes if I'm not feeling it, or if right. I feel just not the one, if I feel ugly, or if I feel like I smell from class or working
right.
out,
exactly.
I will not do it.
Guys like that. Yeah. That shit is disgusting.
Yeah. Yeah. Guys like that.
Yeah. I smell like a long day, and you're ready.
You like that.
If I feel sexy, I'm not going to do it.
Do
it, yeah.
Just
like if I'm not inspired by a song,
then I'm not going to do it.
Then I'm not going to fucking dance. I'm not going to force it. Like, I got it. Sometimes I, like, make myself horny.
Me too.
Seeing myself.
Me too.
Like, just knowing how I feel, knowing what I look like.
Me too.
I perform better. Like, mm-hmm. I'm more spontaneous.
Me too.
And that's when it really, like, that's when it's a really good love.
Yeah.
Time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So
you made me understand that. I didn't get it at first, but then I was like, okay.
Because if I'm lying.
Yeah, because you gotta.
I just.
Because you gotta feel good to perform your best.
You gotta feel
like,
good to perform your
yeah,
best.
Yeah, like you.
Absolutely.
Right. And
it's
like,
gonna be a performance.
It is.
Especially
like
with
sex.
Like us.
Sex is not just gonna be just some like. I mean, and it can be. Like, it can be just some one and done. But if you really want it to like feel good, like you have to feel your best. Like when I feel my best, and I'm like, like it's the best.
Right.
It's the best time. So you just bitch. Because when I don't feel good, I'm like, ooh.
I'm gonna just lay there at that point.
Yeah, I don't. I know I don't look good.
Okay.
I know
that,
I don't look good.
I think for Tally and I. We needed to have the balance of like in a healthy relationship. You guys, you need to tend to each other's needs.
100%.
You know what I'm saying? For me, I'm definitely the type where I could go a little bit. Like when I first started having, once when I was first active, like I was going, mm-hmm. and it's just is what it is. But now that I'm in a relationship, he's damn near my husband. Like I look forward to when it's been a little bit because we've been busy and we're gonna have that night and it's been a while.
Yes.
And it's just like we do something different. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, we did have a conversation about
that one day. It's like what about you guys? Like I'm not, well, I know
you
it's different. I'm not the everydayer. Are you the everydayer? We're being so transparent.
Just real single.
Oh,
I'm just kidding. I'm
shut up.
I'll answer.
Yeah. Okay.
Which one, what was the question? I was
are you an everydayer?
No.
Okay.
I can't. I feel like it's just, when I did play house and I was like living with a boyfriend. It was all cute. I have a high sex drive, but to me it was just kind of like I see you too fucking much.
Mm-hmm.
And then, but that was just like a personal thing within our relationship. Like, we went to school together, we would drive to school together, and then I would see you passing class, and then we would have lunch, and then you want to come home and just.
Yeah,
and
right.
And I'm like, I don't even fucking miss you.
Right.
Do you have an apartment? Can you go there?
It's not exciting.
Yeah, I feel like there needs to be that element. So it does get exciting when you're kind of just.
Mm-hmm.
When you let it be for a little bit.
And,
yes.
And there's other forms of intimacy.
Yes, 100%.
And I feel like I crave that more than I crave
100%.
The actual sex. Like, I just want to feel you and be close to you.
I admire the people who can do an everydayer, though. I kind of admire that. Like, when I watch, like, different movies
over here,
like, and shows.
I'm that kind of person.
And they're just so excited to get it on every single day. And it's like, the anticipation is there. Like when you first started, you know, having sex and it was just like, oh, I can't wait. Like, I admire that, but now my body just doesn't allow me to do that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I am the kind of person that like wants every day. Yeah. I am that person, but I'm also the kind of person that I can just like please myself and go on about my day.
There she is. I'll be
doing
that too.
Yeah. Like it's not necessarily that I need to have sex with Nicole every day,
but
you,
need to
you know,
feel.
I need to do, and then I'm good. But then I am that person that when we have not, when we have not had sex for a long time and then we do and it's so great and it's like, so this is so much better than just doing a little bit of nothing every day. You know what I'm saying? Letting it build up and then have like a great, you know, just a great night, like that's great. But I am the person that's like, oh, like I need.
My mood does change.
From a guy's point of view, or from your point of view, what do you think?
From the average guy's.
He's
point
an every day.
Every day, yeah.
Every day.
Every day, yeah.
Yeah, every day, every day.
I'm like a guy when it comes to that.
But then it's a lot of factors. It depends on your age too, because you know what I'm saying. A lot of guys start realizing as they get older that their performance is getting a little weak or whatever. So you know what I'm saying. It can't be an every day. So hopefully they're not with a girl who wanted every day.
Mm-hmm.
So you know a lot of people think about those guys.
Right.
So,
You know what's really cool? The last thing that I'm going to say about sex that we can share is that sex shouldn't be, well, it could be all sorts of things. Like, I think sex can be like, let's just one and done, yeah, hit it and quit it, or whatever the situation is. But when you're with somebody that you're going to spend the rest of your life with, 100%. We actually use sex to manifest.
100%. Spiritually. Yeah.
Not every time, because it's like each person has to be thinking about what they want to manifest while they're while they're feeling the feeling.
Yeah.
It's new, like, to me.
In this ecstasy. Yeah, no, it's so crazy. You should try it the next time that you're in a grounded relationship, because it can't just be with Joe Schmuck.
It can't just be anybody,
It cannot be with Joe Schmuck.
What y'all manifesting all you do to do?
So we manifested our apartment.
Yeah.
It was so crazy because while we were in the act, we had our laptop open, and it was just like, it was showing a slideshow. It was like showing a slideshow of the of our place. Mm-hmm. And we were both actively thinking, like, we're going to get this. And when you think about your goal and getting it while you're receiving
right. That's kind of like tantric sex.
Anybody who's listening, you guys have to start, like, being productive while you're having sex. It can't just be,
I guess, right, it's beautiful because there's a unit, like, a couple, you guys are in tantric sync with, like, your couple goals.
It's kind of, it's, yes, tantric. Look up tantric sex. That's exactly what that is. Tantric, mm-hmm, tantric sex.
I've never thought
about
it. Bro,
yes.
Taking sex to a whole
nother level. I was just watching a documentary on tantric sex. It's actually, like, really beautiful.
That's also why you gotta be careful of the type of sex that you
have. Yeah, because that shit takes your energy.
You're attracting a certain type of energy.
So for the people who really, like, want to be choked and want to be hurt and like to feel, oop.
I mean, yeah, I'm one of those people.
Jasmine White! She's like, I can't be in this conversation.
Hey, nobody, I mean, it's hard to.
Damn, Gina!
It's hard to.
That dog, my real hang.
It's hard to.
Damn, I am one of those people, though, too.
I like that type. I like that type, too.
Yeah, but that's
what I'm bringing into my life.
But that's a once in a while situation. It's not like I love that. Like,
why do we like that, though? Let's speak about it.
I just like being handled.
Why do we like. Yeah, okay. Tell the difference. Yeah.
There's a difference between when it's a fetish. When it's a fetish, it means, like, it's not happening unless, bitch, I'm handcuffed, you know what I'm saying, to the pole. You need to kick me, put your foot on my head.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Mm. You know, spit on me, all that kind of shit. You know what I'm saying? Mm. You
know? Hit it.
But when it's
hit
like. Every once in a while, you know, you want to be aggressive.
Yeah, it's just like a moment.
Feel some power.
Exactly.
We
it's a moment.
We want to feel like our man
is like, ugh, yeah.
But then.
Yeah.
Jasmine wants it.
Jasmine's like, I want that every day, so I'm confused.
You want that whipping.
She want that whip. Whip, bitch. She's like, I want this weave to be pulled the fuck. I hate her.
I get it,
because I'm that person.
But
I'm that person, too.
I'm really
dominant.
But
why
in my
feel
life?
Pain?
Not necessarily.
I don't want actual pain, though. Like, you ain't about to be, like, choking me until I can't breathe.
Oh, some people be like, slap.
No.
Oh, no. No. I'm talking about, like a cute little.
I'm telling on you.
I'm telling on you. This is assault. Like, I don't know, like a cute little handcuff and a cute little. But, I mean, when you're having sex like that with a person that you know you're safe with, I feel like it's different. Like, I just feel like it's a moment. It's different, and you know, like I ask for that. So it's just kind of, I don't know. I feel like it depends. I just feel like that depends.
Maybe for a cute little, maybe like for 2 seconds as opposed to like 10. Like, let me just feel it. For
let
a
me
second,
just
and then
yeah,
let's
and then
back.
Let's go back. Right. I feel
now,
that.
I'm just a really dominant person in my everyday life. Like, I take control of everything. I'm a type A type of person. I like to know what's going on and have my hand in everything. So when it comes to sex and things like that, like I said, you have to be something worth submitting to for me to do that.
Right.
But when you can do that, it's like, oh, I can, like, take a step back and I feel like I can just enjoy that moment of being carefree and being taken care of in an abusive sexual manner.
Yes,
but I like it because it's different from my everyday life.
Right.
I'm already tapping into, like, a different side of me.
Exactly.
Because it's very business oriented, very straightforward every single day.
So you want this.
Yeah.
So
you
an intention. Yeah.
Some people just don't know.
They don't. They just,
so when a man can do that, I'm like,
right.
Noted.
Yeah.
Okay. What do you like? I mean, do you like to do that? Do you like to kind of, I know you're kind of like doing all that.
I'll just say this. I'm the mystical, magical, spiritual guy.
Right.
Okay? What I've noticed is that my relationship with women, when my sexual preferences in that relationship were like more like masculine domination or whatever, it was my relationship with the feminine energy was not good. Until I switched it or whatnot and took a different approach, then it felt like every woman in my life, whether it was intimate or relationship, just had a different energy towards me, and it felt better. So I'm that guy, so I'm kind of more like, you know what I'm saying, make love to you. I show you when I know you want it, because I know we've had those moments.
Yeah.
Or whatever, and I could tell when you want me to, you know what I'm saying.
Let go.
Yeah,
then, you know, there's an invitation to that, you know what I'm saying, the energy.
Right, and I think that it depends, because I've been, I like shit like that, but I've also been in situations where a man has done something like that to me, and I've been like, like, I feel uncomfortable, and I don't like that, and I need you to not do it. Versus me being like in
I feel like the woman needs to show.
Versus me being in a relationship and being like, I want you to just tear me the fuck up.
You want a guy who understands without you
telling them
what to do.
Exactly.
There it is.
Exactly.
If a guy doesn't know you well enough to know where the line is, then y'all should have been doing what you're doing.
Exactly. 100%. 100%. 100%.
That's the biggest part.
Thank you.
How long has it been?
I hate
gone?
It.
Okay.
Oh, shit. Okay, great. Wrap it up. Great. Cool.
Is there anything else that we want to say or that we want to get out there, honey? Is there anything that
I don't think so.
I mean, you know, this subject can go on
for hours. I know. We can get deep.
Stopping point.
We can get deep.
Yeah. Well, either way, if you're having sex, make sure you're protected. Make sure we're clean. Mm-hmm. And make sure
Please
you're making the right choices.
Yeah. And protect.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. And protect your energy.
That might be. Fun.
Yeah, right.
No, I can't breathe.
Wear a mask.
Wear a mask during sex.
I don't even want to wear that shit out.
No, I'd be kind of here for that. Cover up their facials.
Cover up their facials.
Oh.
That's smart, right?
You know, but I feel like that would be like a little role play, a little robbery.
Not a robbery with a ski mask on. That's what you're talking about.
The rock.
I hate it.
Anyway, y'all.
I hate that a lot.
Oh, God.
Like I said, we got my honey up in the building. Say what's up.
Hey.
We got sis up in the building.
Say what's up.
Hey. We got Jazz up in the building.
Say what's up.
Hey. And like I said, we're very much in the beginning of this journey, so we might be upgrading our
Hell
location
yeah.
and our tools. So make sure to stay tuned for that. But yeah, I think that's it for after class.
Cute.
You guys have an amazing day, whatever you guys are doing. And we'll talk to y'all next episode after class. Peace.